The world could care less, and you have to persuade them, and you have to show that you're the one person out there that can do it.
These are the richest billionaires in the world. Not only are they self-made billionaires, but they produced a product that still stands to this day. Welcome to the Entrepreneur Central. Make sure before the video loads up to leave a like, comment if you leave the like, and subscribe. Those who enter in our subscriber giveaway have a chance at getting a shout out if you do those three things right there. These self-made billionaires are completely rich until the day they die. And you're gonna see a lot of them who are worth billions of dollars. Let's jump right into it. First up, we have Evan Spiegel. Evan Spiegel is the co-founder and CEO of Snapchat, the popular picture-taking app that allows you to send selfies, videos, and even group call in group texts. His net worth as of the 8th of November is $3.1 billion. He is only under the age of 30 years old. Spiegel co-founded the company with his partner, Bobby Murphy, a Stanford University fraternity brother in 2011, and the business took off ever since then. Spiegel and Murphy own about each 18% of Snapchat, but have the voting shares that give them control over the entire board. Spiegel graduated from Stanford with a bachelor's degree in product design in 2018, 6 years after he first dropped out first to start Snapchat. I get that he wants to go back to school, and I applaud him for that, but he's never really going to need that university degree anyways. Spiegel has actually donated nearly $65 million in Snap stock. He and Murphy have pledged to donate 13 million shares to the Snap Foundation. A little background about him: his self-made score on ForbesList.com is 8, his philanthropy score is 2, that is a hard word to say. He resides actually in Los Angeles, California. He's from the United States, he's married to his lovely wife, and has 2 children. When he first started Snapchat back in 2011, not many people used it. It wasn't seen as an app that would be safe for a lot of people. As you guys know, anything you put out into that worldwide space of web can be stuck there forever, even if it's permanently deleted from your device. But the stocks ended up booming over 200% in 2014, which allowed him to grow the company's stocks and also make sure the company's type of background was a pure one. As it was purely developing, he actually ended up going full-time with it and was very, very lucky to hit the stock worth of 500% back in 2015 as it grew over the years. So where does that $3.1 billion come from? It comes from the 18% of shares that he owns in Snapchat, as well as his stocks he holds too. So you can definitely look up to Evan Spiegel as a self-made billionaire on this list. But surprisingly, he isn't even the richest one. This name brings a lot of controversy because she's a Jenner. But Kylie Jenner is actually next up on our list. Her net worth is $1 billion, and at 21, the celebrity-turned-makeup mogul Kylie Jenner is the youngest self-made billionaire to ever exist. She is only worth $1 billion. She's going up tremendously as her net worth and her stock is growing by the day. Jenner, who started out peddling $29 lip kits in 2015, sold an estimated $360 million worth of Kylie Cosmetics in 2018. In November of 2018, Jenner launched a distribution deal with beauty retailer Ulta and sold an estimated $55 million of product in just 6 weeks. In May of 2019, she announced the launch of her vegan Kylie Skin line, which absolutely boomed, and she recently filed a trademark for a possible baby line to expand her net worth and grow the company in total. Thanks to its super low overhead and massive sales, the company is worth at least $900 million, and Jenner owns a 100% stake in it. So she hasn't really given it up to any investors or asked for any equity or anything from them. She is comfortable with running it herself. As aside from that, she used $250,000 of her earnings from the modeling gigs to pay an outside company to produce her first 15,000 lip kits. As 2019 comes to an end and 2020's coming up, Jenner has actually recently announced she wants to partner with a lot of beauty moguls such as Jeffree Star and Shane Dawson and all those other people who are participating in the popular phenomenon known as drag queens, and they want to go ahead and get different types of makeup kits out there. Another reason why her net worth is so big is because she's also the baby mother to famous rapper and hip-hop artist Travis Scott. He has a really big net worth, not as big as a billion obviously, but he's worth a couple hundred million as well, so it goes hand in hand with how they work together. Recently they just split, so I'll be very interested to see how the future works out for both of them. On this list, he is the richest guy here, and that's Mark Zuckerberg. His net worth is at $70.6 billion. If you guys remember back in 2010-2011, Zuckerberg started Facebook. It actually boomed right away because people didn't have an app they can go on where they can talk to their friends they haven't talked in a while. They could also get news, sports types of scores, and they can also contact any type of business employer through it. It was kind of like an Indeed job type source as well as mixed with a Twitter aspect of the social media app. After facing another year of criticism for allowing fake news on Facebook, CEO Mark Zuckerberg said his priority in 2019 coming up is tackling social issues. In July of 2019 that just passed, the Federal Trade Commission fined Facebook $5 billion, its largest penalty in history, for violating consumers' privacy. There was a little bit of a rumor going around, and this could be true, that they were collecting personal information through messages, profile visits, and also a lot of insider information that people like to keep secret because of the app. Well, he took Facebook public in May 2012 and still owns about 15% of the stock. And back in 2015, Zuckerberg and his wife Priscilla Chan pledged to give away 99% of their Facebook stake over their lifetimes. So this basically means whenever they are long dead and gone, they will give 99% of the stock away, and the other 1% will remain with other shareholders or current ones at the time. This dude is a business mogul, and he's approaching Jeff Bezos to reach the $100 billion mark, so it'll be interesting to see how far he goes in that direction. Ultimately, these people on this list have done it all themselves. They started with nothing. Even though they had big investments from either family members or close relatives and friends, they still worked their butts off to get to the position they're in. So if you guys are trying to go this route, never say never and work your butt off to get there. Guys, I'm signing off, and as always, see y'all later.